are.
Huh?
Tell me what you eat, and I'll tell you what you are.
Huh?
Tell me what you eat, and I'll tell you what you are.
Huh?
Tell me what you eat, and I'll tell you what you are.
You know what that means?
No.
Tell me what you eat, and I'll tell you what you are. I don't get it.
Tell me what you eat, and I'll tell you what you are means that if you know about the foods that go into you, you'll know how you can look good, feel good, and do good in the things you try.
Tell me what you eat, and I'll tell you what you are. Well, pretty good, huh? Oh!
You expect him to eat this stuff?
We expect him.
Mickey, this is horrible.
I told you, what did you do to him?
Nothing. Look, I read the ingredients and...
Okay, did you put one egg?
You sure you put one egg?
Okay,
I put one egg.
How much milk?
We don't have any milk.
This is you know who.
You know who?
Yes, you know who.
Who's you know who?
Me, Wilbur Do Right.
Hey, kids, it's Wilbur Do Right.
Shh. Will you be quiet? You never know who might be listening.
Oh, Wilbur.
So listen, I just saw the big boss.
The big boss?
Yes, the big boss.
Well, we just saw the big boss!
Hey, the big boss, man!
Will you be quiet? You want to give the whole thing away to the enemy?
Enemy? Wilbur, don't be silly!
Now listen, I have an assignment for you and the Mulligan Stew, if you can handle it.
An assignment? Oh, sure, Wilbur, come on over!
Okay, now, here's my plan. I'm going to come right on over.
And don't bother to knock. The door is always open.
And I'm not even going to bother to knock. You'll leave the door open for me so that I can slip right in.
Okay, Wilbur. I'll see you when you get over here. Hey, kids. Wilbur's coming over with an assignment. That'll be fun.
Okay, now. Don't act suspicious or anything. And above all, stay calm. We mustn't lose our heads.
To know what's happening in the good eating scene, you have to know a little about digestion.
Digestion. The process of making food absorbable by dissolving it and breaking it down into simpler chemical compounds in the alimentary canal for assimilation into the body system.
Yes, Chef, Chef, Wilbur, do right!
Me?
A stuffed shirt? Well, that's preposterous.
Well, here we go. We're about to be eaten.
Oh, yeah? That's out of sight. I've never been eaten before.
Me neither, but I hear it's not that bad.
But what happens in there?
Well, you know how the body is made up of millions and millions of cells?
Yeah.
Well, that guy's got to eat us foods so that each of those cells can be fed to live and grow.
We're gonna go right into the cell.
No, first he eats us foods, then he digests us.
Digest?
Yeah, it's a process that breaks us down into the parts that his cells need to live and grow.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, the guy's gonna pick us up on his fork and eat us. I'll explain it all to you as we go along.
I'm ready when you are.
Here we go.
Hey, where are we?
This is the guy's mouth. Digestion starts here. He chews us up with his teeth into smaller parts so we can have an easy trip down his throat.
That's why you have to have good teeth, right?
Right.
Hey, what's going on?
Take it easy, take it easy. That's just saliva.
Saliva?
You know, spit.
Oh, spit. Why didn't you say so?
Okay. The saliva has stuff in it that starts to change some foods, like carbohydrates, into sugar.
Well, that's all well and good, but does it have to make us so wet?
Well, that's so we'll be easier to swallow and go down a guy's throat. And here we go!
Whee! Now, where do we go now?
The throat, or as it is called, the esophagus, will take us to the stomach for more digesting.
Wow, the stomach sure is a groovy place.
Yeah, and here comes some more digestive fluids, and the stomach walls will move around and churn so that we can be mixed up a little more with digestion.
No, this is fun. I want to be digested more.
Okay, now that we're a liquid substance, we're going into the small intestine.
What happens then, more fun?
You'll see. And we're passing through the stomach into the small intestine now.
Oh boy, this is like a magic land.
It sure is. Okay, here in the small intestine, we're going to be broken down into different parts, like fatty acids and amino acids.
For building new cells.
Right, and simple sugars. Then we'll be absorbed through the intestinal walls and go into the bloodstream.
Where to now?
Now? Well, we each go to the cells that need us the most. Some of us will repair damaged or tired cells. Others will build new ones. Some of us will be stored up for use later.
Boy, this was the best voyage I ever took.
Me too. See you later, pal.
See ya.
And don't forget, the next time we see each other, we'll be parts of this guy's cells.
Wahoo!
You can't be on top of it mentally or physically unless you eat right. That means a balanced diet.
You can't be a good athlete, a good student, a good musician, or a good anything unless everything is working right. And to get everything to work right, you have to eat right.
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 How about these?
Now that's what I call pancakes.
Here I am.
Kit? It's me, Wilbur Do-Right, fourth assistant, the second helper of the eighth person in the line of the Department of Important News. Maggie? It's me, Wilbur. Mike, will you listen? I have some important news. Mickey? Money? Mulligan? This is vital. I have an assignment for the Mulligan Stew Force. Your country needs you!
Gee, Wilbur, why didn't you say so?
How long have you been here, Wilbur?
What's happening, Wilbur?
Hey, Wilbur, how you doing?
Hi.
Holy cow, it's Wilbur Do-Right. What's up?
I have an assignment for the Mulligan Stew Force, if you think you can handle it.
Okay.
Here's a film of a boy and his sister. This is Bobby Jenkins, a typical 15-year-old boy and his 14-year-old sister. Now, Bobby and his sister Alice were very popular in school, went to all the parties, good-looking too, used to date all the time.
What do you mean, used to?
Wait and you'll see. Bobby was voted most popular in school, and he excelled in sports.
Wow.
Wow is right. Now, Alice was the most popular girl in the school. Cheerleader, booster, acted in the school plays.
What happened, Wilbur?
Here they are as they look now. See how grouchy they act? Their friends don't even like them anymore.
Really?
Yes. Their grades are way, way down in school. Their friends don't want to hang around with them because they're so grouchy and uptight all the time. Here are the facts and figures on Bobby and Alice Jenkins. Your assignment, Mulligan Stew, if you think you can handle it, is to find out what's wrong with Bobby and Alice and fix it.
Golly, looks like a tough one.
But can you do it, Mulligan Stew? Can you solve this riddle?
We can and we will.
Wilbur, you're not thinking of...
I mean, last time, Wilbur, we...
Oh, no, Wilbur.
What's the trouble?
Oh, nothing, Wilbur. Everything's just fine.
Substances to live and grow.
And these substances are called nutrients.
One of the key nutrients you've got to know about is protein.
Proteins build and repair the cells of our bodies.
We get protein from the foods in the meat group, the milk group, and the bread and cereals group.
Let's hear from protein.
Minerals are another important nutrient.
Iron and calcium are important minerals to remember. So is iodine.
Iron is needed by your red blood cells to carry oxygen to your body. Without iron, we'd feel sick and tired and run down.
We get iron in the foods from the meat group, the fruit and vegetable group, and the bread and cereal group.
Calcium helps to build strong bones and strong teeth.
It also helps keep your heart beating and helps your muscles to work.
Get calcium in the foods from the milk group and the fruits and vegetables group.
Vitamins are another important nutrient.
Vitamin A helps you see in the dark.
We get vitamin A from the fruits and vegetable group and the milk group.
The B vitamins help us get energy from food. They help keep the nerves and the skin in good condition. They also help you have a good, healthy appetite.
B vitamins, they're found in cereal,
milk, vegetables, meats, in those four food groups.
Let's hear it for the B vitamin.
Vitamin C is very important.
Vitamin C helps hold our body cells together. It makes the walls of our blood vessels strong. It also helps to heal wounds.
Vitamin C is found in citrus fruits and other fruits and vegetables, too.
Let's hear it for vitamin C.
Other important key nutrients carbohydrates and fats.
Carbohydrates and fats give us energy for work and play and school and sports.
Carbohydrates come from foods that have starches and sugar. Starches are found in bread and cereal.
And corn and potato.
Sugar can be found in honey, syrup, table sugars, jams, and jellies.
Fats can be found in butter and margarine
and cooking fats and oils.
Let's hear it for fat and carbohydrates. Yeah!
There they are, Bobby and Alice. I told them to meet us in the stands.
I sure hope we can do something to help them.
Me too.
Well, first we gotta figure out what's wrong with them. Then we gotta do something about it.
And that's the story. Always grouchy and tired.
Right. My friends say I'm not much fun anymore. And I haven't had a date in weeks.
Maybe you could, sorry.
Now, we've got to find out what caused this change in you. You used to be the most popular guy in school, right, Bobby?
Yeah, used to be.
Now look at us. We're all pooped out like we were old paper, grouchy and uptight.
What do you think, Mulligan?
Yeah, did you figure it out?
Come on, tell us, tell us.
Okay, then. Here's my plan. Now, we've got to examine Bobby and Alice and what they do every day. And maybe that'll give us some clues to why they've become so tired and run down lately and irritable.
That'll take a lot of work, Marvin.
Not if Bobby and Alice help us. Now, you've got to tell us what you do on a regular date, okay?
Okay with me.
Me too.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's begin.
Oh, Wilbur.
Well, we get up in the morning and we wash.
Right. Bobby uses the bathroom first while I brush my hair.
Then I come out and do a few exercises while Alice uses the bathroom. And I don't do my exercises anymore. Too tired and worn out, even in the morning.
What happens then?
Well, after we get dressed, we grab our books and start for school.
Sure. We don't want to be late for school, do we?
Heavens, no.
Don't you even stop for breakfast?
We already told you we don't want to be late for school.
Only we're so drowsy all the time. We don't do well in school anyway.
Yeah.
What happens then?
First comes lunch break.
What do you have for lunch?
Oh, man, I get a great lunch. Meat and vegetables, milk and dessert. Then I play some ball.
I grab a sandwich and milk in the cafeteria and eat it outside with my friends.
Then you go back into school?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
What about after school?
Well, I usually go to one of my friends' house.
Do you have a snack over there?
Sure, potato chips and soda pop, you know.
How about you, Bobby?
Well, I used to have football practice in the afternoons. Then me and the guys would horse around, you know. Now I just watch.
You have a snack, too?
Sure. Sometimes we get something at the candy store or malt shop. Once in a while, we have a hot dog.
Okay, how about supper?
I eat everything my mom puts out for us.
Me too. I'm really hungry. Well, do you think you can help us?
I think so. But first, I've got to check some things out with some of my friends.
Who?
Some kids I know.
Oh, what can they do?
I'm not sure, but they know a lot about problems like these.
Just don't stand there. Go find them.
I've got these two friends, and their name is Bobby and Alice Jenkins, you know? And they're all grouchy and uptight all the time. And I figure, you know, like, maybe it's due to the fact that they don't eat right.
Well, do they have good lunches?
They eat good lunch, they told me.
Do they eat breakfast?
No, they don't.
That might be it.
Well, in 4-H, we're learning different things about how breakfast could be good for you, and that if you don't eat breakfast, you get all grumpy and get headaches during the day.
My name is Maggie, and I'm conducting a series of interviews on food and nutrition. Could you tell me what you had for breakfast this morning?
A piece of toast, a glass of milk.
What did you have for breakfast this morning?
I had 2 eggs and bacon this morning and toast.
and a glass of milk.
Bacon and eggs, orange juice and coffee.
Sauce and eggs.
Do you think breakfast is important?
Yes.
Why?
Well, get your day started.
God gets you started for the day.
Keep you from getting hungry through the day.
Because it gives you something to run your energy on.
Do you know what formula 4-4-3-2 stands for?
No.
Okay. 4 servings a day of fruit and vegetables you should have every day. And 4 servings of bread and cereals. 3 servings a day of milk and cheese. And 2 of meat, fish, or chicken. What does food give you?
Well, too much of it gets me fat. I guess it gives me energy, huh?
Well, if you eat the proper foods, it won't get you fat. How do you know eating good is important?
You're not able to do very much if you don't eat good.
You have to eat good to feel good, especially breakfast.
You can't be good at what you want to be. A nurse, a doctor, a dancer, a lawyer, a fireman. Unless you eat a balanced diet, the right foods, the right exercise, the right rest. All the parts.
That was very good, Wilbur.
Yes, I know.
You have to know what foods you need to have a healthy body.
I want to know what we're doing here. I thought we were supposed to be solving the problem for Bobby and Alice.
That's exactly why we came here.
Well, I don't get it.
Me neither.
Don't worry, Wilbur. You will. I'm sure Mulligan knows what he's doing.
Golly, I sure hope so.
Okay, Bobby and Alice, you sit here. Okay, Mulligans, now let's set up.
Kids? Yeah. Kids, what are you doing?
Just relax and enjoy yourself, Wilbur. It'll all be very clear in a minute. Ready? This will solve your problems. 1, 2, 3, 4.
We won't, man.
Breakfast, that's for us from now on.
Yeah. Your body is made up of millions and millions of cells.
To keep your cells healthy and repair damaged cells and build new ones, we need nutrients.
Nutrients come from the foods you eat every day. Your body needs nutrients to live and grow.
Proteins are nutrients.
Vitamins are nutrients.
Minerals like iron, calcium, and iodine are nutrients.
Carbohydrates and fats are nutrients.
Like man, you need nutrients to live and grow.
You need nutrients to live and grow.
And 1, 2, 3, 4. You need nutrients to live and grow. Yeah!
Remember, 4-4-3-2.
You need 4 servings of fruits and vegetables. You can get 1 or more at breakfast.
You need 4 from the bread and cereal group. You can get 1 or more at breakfast.
You need 3 servings from the milk group. You can get 1 at breakfast. And 2 from the meat group. You can get 1 at breakfast.
Got it.
And thanks. We'll never forget what we've learned.
Yeah, thanks, Mulligans. Oh, thank you too, Wilbur.
Thanks, Wilbur.
Oh, it was nothing.
You have to eat the right foods to look good, feel good, and do good in the things you try. There's really no other way to do it other than eating right.
I eat right. Do you?
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 We eat right. Do you?
Inside.